While still a virgin at 30, Adachi Kiyoshi gains a magical power, the ability to read other people's minds by touching them. At first, he's overwhelmed by his new ability, and it's not proving to be helpful to him. But that all changes when he accidentally touches Kurosawa Yuichi, whom he learns has romantic feelings for him. And this show is also based off of a manga. The main couple. So in this show, the main couple is, of course, Adachi and Kurosawa, as we heard from the description. And now Adachi is a very shy and awkward little being, and I love him very much. He's very endearing to me personally. And Kurosawa is pretty much the exact opposite. Kurosawa is very confident. He's considered the best employee. Everybody loves him. Everyone thinks he's handsome, etc., etc. The genre. So I would consider the genre of this show to be fluff and comedy. And if you don't know what fluff is, it's considered like it's light and fluffy. Like the show doesn't have any like super dark moments. Even if there is a little bit of drama, it's not anything super, super heavy and dark. Trigger warnings. So in this show, I do not believe there are any trigger warnings. And by trigger warnings, I mean non-consensual stuff. I mean cheating, things like that. And in my opinion, in my perspective, there are none in this show. If you think differently and you have seen trigger warnings in this show, please leave them down below. But I do not think there are any. Kisses. All right, so I know this might not be important to some people, but it is important to some people. So I wanted to include this section. In this show, there are zero kisses. There is one implied kiss, but honestly, and there are some shows where I think the lack of physical affection does affect the show together. But in this show, I think it was fine that there wasn't a kiss. Honestly, it really did work. It didn't affect my opinion of the show at all. Chemistry. So chemistry, I mean between the main couple, Adachi and Kurosawa. I would say their chemistry is a 7 out of 10, which I consider very, very good. It's not, oh my God, they have the best chemistry ever in the world. And it's definitely not that they have no chemistry at all. I think they have a good amount and they really work with each other really well. A very important question. Is Cherry Magic a happy ending? Yes, Cherry Magic does have a happy ending. And we love to see it, everyone. Do we not? We love ourselves a happy ending. Quality of production. So by quality of production, I mean camera work, cinematography, lighting, things like that, like sound quality. And this show, nothing ever took me out of the show at all. So, you know, there are some shows where the camera work obviously is a little shaky, obviously a little janky. And this show didn't have any of that. If anything, I think it's a little above my expectations, honestly. They had some really beautiful shots and some really beautiful cinematography in this show. And I think it was really well done. Quality of acting. So this is pretty self-explanatory. I think the acting in all the characters in the show, I think it was really good. Again, just like the production, it never took me out of the story. Nothing ever was kind of so obvious. Like the acting wasn't so weird or so bad that I was like, oh, yikes, like they're acting. Their acting was really good. And I think it's very much in the style of this show. I would say the acting might be a little bit exaggerated, but I mean, this show has one of the main characters with magical power, so you know, it really works. My overall opinion of the show. This show, I think, to me, is the most fluffy, non-problematic BL I've probably ever seen, and I think it's super fucking cute, and it even has, like, some really good life lessons in there, too, which we love to see. Do I recommend this show? Well, obviously, yes. If I said no, I think y'all would just click off right now. And now a very, very important question. If you now want to watch the show, where can you watch it? So in my region, which is, I'm in the USA, it is kind of hard to watch this show from the actual provider or producer of the show. So I had to go to Dailymotion. And that's just for my region. So if you're from somewhere else, maybe like leave down below where you could watch it as well in your region. But yeah, Daily Motion is kind of the only place I found it that I can watch it without having to go to a weird website that will definitely give my computer a virus. So yeah, I really hope y'all watch it. And I think that's all for today, guys. I really hope you liked this kind of video and it was helpful to you in some way. I really wanted to make like a very short and concise video just for people who really kind of wanted the bare minimum facts without spoilers if they want to watch a show or not. Because I think this would be really helpful to myself if I had it. And because then even when you try to Google things like, oh, is it a happy ending? Then inevitably you probably end up with a spoiler somewhere and it ruins something for you. So I hope this helped. And I want to just thank Madam iMadam again. Hi. Because we were talking about this. They had suggested this in a comment and I was already thinking about doing videos like this to begin with. And they kind of just pushed me to do it now. So there are definitely going to be a lot more of these because I've seen a lot of shows. So let me know if there's anything I should add to kind of the sections of this that would be non-spoilerish that, you know, maybe you would like to know as well. And comment down below if you watch the show or if you have different opinions, because that's fine. But please, 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 no spoilers. That's literally the point of this video. All right, guys. Bye.